Coronaviruses comprise a vast family of viruses, some of which are known to cause disease in humans. Severe acute respiratory syndrome, SARS, and Middle East respiratory syndrome, MERS, are examples of coronaviruses that jumped from animals to humans. COVID-19 is defined as an illness caused by a novel coronavirus called severe acute respiratory syndrome coronavirus 2. The main route of COVID-19 transmission is through exposure to infectious respiratory droplets. Additional methods include contact transmission, as shaking hands, airborne transmission of droplets that linger in the air over long distances, usually greater than 6 feet. Viruses released in respiratory secretions, during coughing, sneezing, talking, can infect other individuals via contact with mucous membranes. The risk of transmission from an individual with SARS-CoV-2 infection varies by the variant of the virus, duration of exposure, and the proper use of preventive measures. Here are some comorbidities that increase the risk of severe COVID-19 illness: COPD, chronic obstructive pulmonary disease, asthma, heart conditions, heart failure, coronary artery disease, cardiomyopathies, cancer, and immunocompromised people, chronic kidney disease, and obesity. As of August 21, 2021, confirmed COVID-19 infections are over 210 million individuals worldwide and have resulted in over 4.2 million deaths. Based on Johns Hopkins University and Medicine report, the mortality rate from COVID-19 in the United States is 1.7%. COVID-19 death rates were highest among males, older adults, non-Hispanic American Indian, and Hispanic persons. Incubation is the period between the moment we catch the virus and the development of signs and symptoms. The duration of viral shedding varies significantly and may depend on severity. In COVID disease, we are contagious 48 hours before the development of signs and symptoms. Presentations of COVID-19 range from asymptomatic, mild symptoms to severe illness and mortality. The most notable manifestation of COVID-19 appears to be a fever, cough, loss of taste or smell, and fatigue. Some other symptoms are sore throat, runny nose, OR congestion, gastrointestinal disturbance. In less common cases, the signs are more severe, as shortness of breath, chest pain, and altered mental status. The presence of COVID-19 signs or exposure to an infected person requires the person to seek diagnostic tests to rule out COVID-19 infection. The standard testing methods for the presence of SARS-CoV-2 are nucleic acid tests, which detect the presence of viral RNA fragments. This PCR test is also called a molecular test. Antigen testing is the other PCR method. It looks for specific proteins of the virus. Both PCR methods are done by a swab sample collected from the nose, throat, or saliva. Unlike PCR testing, serology is not a viable option to detect active COVID-19 disease. Serology testing is a collection of a blood sample and looking for antibodies that are created against COVID-19. This test confirms previous exposure and infection to the virus and is done after recovery from COVID. Management of COVID-19 is supportive care, which includes treatment to relieve symptoms and varies by disease severity. Many patients with known or suspected COVID-19 have a mild disease that does not warrant hospital-level care. Supportive care includes medication such as Tylenol to relieve symptoms. Having such patients recover at home is preferred. It prevents additional potential exposures in the healthcare setting and reduces the healthcare system's burden. Moderate to severe cases require hospitalization and more aggressive interventions to maintain adequate oxygen levels in the blood using non-invasive ventilation. Ultimately, admission to an intensive care unit for mechanical ventilation may be required to support breathing. Prone positioning showed improved ventilation. The use of corticosteroids improves survival in hospitalized patients with severe COVID-19 disease requiring supplemental oxygen. Remdesivir, an antiviral agent, was the first drug approved for the treatment of COVID-19. To prevent catching the disease, we need to avoid getting the virus into our bodies. Some measures to attain this goal are to maintain at least 6 feet of distance between each other in public and to avoid large gatherings indoors. Hand hygiene after touching objects, surfaces, and before touching the face. CDC recommends getting a COVID-19 vaccine as soon as possible. Vaccines to prevent SARS-CoV-2 infection are considered the most promising approach for curbing the pandemic and are being vigorously pursued. Will it end the pandemic? You will know the answer in a bit. The main goal of the vaccination is to reduce the severity of the disease if we catch it in the future. A vaccinated person will still be contagious and may still experience signs and symptoms of the COVID-19. However, the vaccine is associated with fewer admissions to intensive care. Complications of COVID-19 have included pneumonia, acute respiratory distress syndrome is known as ARDS, cardiac injury, cardiac arrhythmias, septic shock, liver dysfunction, acute kidney injury, multi-organ failure, and cytokine storm, which is often the cause of death in COVID-19 diseases. Although most people with COVID-19 get better within weeks of illness, some people experience post-COVID conditions. Quoted by CDC. These cases are now referred to as chronic COVID, long COVID, or post-COVID. It is when the signs and symptoms persist for more than 4 weeks. This crucial subject is still under study and data collection. This will be a topic we will discuss in more detail in another video. If any of the following questions interest you, please pause the screen to read the answers. Since COVID-19 remains a new disease to us, there is a lot of the unknown, and institutions are still collecting data to understand it better. In the next video, we will explain what are the variants of COVID-19, how they happen, and much more. Thank you for joining us in yet another video covering key health-related topics with medicalarts official. If you have any questions or comments, please leave below. Make sure to subscribe to our channel to learn about new releases. Thank you.